Gudlur, which is in beautiful Nilgiri Hills. I must confess that I am no psychiatrist. What little psychiatry I know, I learned in my old age. Dr. Jacob said you can't teach an old dog new tricks, but I did learn. So I think it's still possible. We did a community-based mental health program for the last 5 years. It's been going on, and I would like to talk a little about that. And it says the hidden burden of mental illness, and I strongly believe that a lot of the burden of mental illness is very much hidden. I worked in the community for about 15 years before we realized that there was so much of a problem within the community, although we were working so closely with them. As to the background of Ashwini, it was started in 1990 in the, to cater to the health needs of the tribals of the Gudlur Valley. The vision was to have community-owned institutions and healthcare systems. About 20,000-25,000 tribals inhabit the Gudlur Valley. They live in small hamlets that are spread out all over. So access is still a very big problem, and each of these hamlets only has about 20 to 30 families very often. There are issues because of poverty, illiteracy, the usual. But the main issue is because of the lack of understanding of the mainstream culture and what it is that we are all talking about. They just don't understand that. They're totally lost. So we have been working for 2 decades on improving the healthcare of this community, and we've been focusing on maternal health and child health. We've been able to bring about dramatic improvement in these. As you can see, the infant mortality rate was 250 per thousand when we started, and now this last year, I'm happy to say it's only 20 per thousand. That's a huge achievement, and even the maternal mortality is a very rare occurrence now. Deaths from diarrhea, tuberculosis, all these kind of things are almost unheard of in this community now. But and also we have set up a 40-bed secondary care based hospital, and we have 8 area centers that cater to the population to make access to care easier. But in 2004, we were shocked to find that suicides were the second commonest cause of death. And it was really, really a shock. We also realized that we had 75 patients on treatment for mental illness. And we were not doing a good job at all. The patients did not have any faith in us. The families did not have any faith in us. There was no continuity of care. We didn't know what we were doing. And it was a bad scene. Our lack of knowledge and lack of protocols really did not help at all. So we said we have to do something about this, and we set off starting up this community mental health program with the support of SRTT. And as you all know, SRTT, those of you who have been involved with SRTT know how they back you up. And thank goodness for their backup, we were able to set up something good. As with all our programs, everything starts from the community and comes back before we implement the programs. Everything's discussed at the community, and it's a bottom-to-top approach. And in one of our discussions with the staff, we said, so how many of you think that mental illness is a disease, and how many of you think that we should go ahead and treat it with medications? About 40 staff were there in that room that day, and these are all people who have been working in the health field, doing complicated tasks for more than 10 years. Only one person put up a hand. Everybody else thought it was a curse or something of that sort. To that extent is the lack of awareness of mental illness in the communities. So we did a survey in 184 hamlets, and the findings were no different. There was only about 13% of the people who believed that it could even be cured. Everybody else thought it was whatever, whatever. And only 23% of the people surveyed believed that some kind of medical help, be it traditional medicine or allopathy, would be useful for these patients. As for the implementation, we had a 3-day training workshop, and we had some very good people helping us with this thing. There was Dr. Kishore Kumar from NIMHANS. There was Dr. K.S. Jacob from CMC. So a lot of our friends, the psychiatrists, helped us with implementing the program. In the first 3 days, Dr. Kishore demystified mental illness. what we didn't know about psychosis, depression, bipolar, the works, there were role plays and everything, and we had a good understanding of what we were getting into. With this knowledge, we started training 40 health volunteers. And they were trained in very basic things. The basics of detecting symptoms of mental illness, the need for regular treatment, the need for rehabilitation.